3D graphics can really enhance the user experience, bringing fun to any website or application. In today's video, I'm going to introduce you to a new tool called Spline. Spline is a 3D design tool that you can easily create and publish 3D web experiences. You can also build and iterate fast with production-ready results. Also embed them into your website or application just by pasting a line of code. If you're new here, hi, what's up? I'm Gemma and I'm a senior product designer who shares tips about UX for free. If that's something you're interested in, then why not hit that subscribe button. Turn on the notification bell to get notified every time I upload a new video. With that said, let's go take a look at Spline, where I'll show you how to use it and implement it onto a website. So, let's go. So let's take a look at Spline's website. So we'll head over to spline.design and straight away you can see what the tool can offer. As you scroll down, it gives you a bit more information about the tool. All this is completely interactive, what I find really cool. But what is good about this tool right now is that you can either download and install it, and they offer for quite a lot of operating systems. So you got Mac, you got Windows, and you got Linux, but also now they offer an in-browser experience. So let's open up Spline within the browser. I do also have it installed, but I think it'd be cool to check out the browser experience. The browser version is exactly the same as the downloadable version. So within the tool itself, you can see all down the side here, I have my files, activity, library, learn, updates and settings. Here are all my files that I currently created. And there's also some little examples down here of what you can get from the library. I don't have anything in the activity for now. Library, again, what I just talked about, you can see a range of Spline projects that you can open up and actually start playing about with these files. You can change all the colors or just get a lot of inspiration from these files if you don't know where to start. Then in the learn section, we have a bunch of links that you can check out, and then it has a lot of shortcuts that you can refer to later if you're a shortcut kind of person. With that said, let's now create a new file. So when you create a new file, it does drop in a shape for you, and you do also start with a dark background, but you are also able to change that background, whether or not you know the hex code, or you can just choose a predefined color or choose your own. I'm just going to give you an overview of the tool itself. Pretty much set up just like any other design tool that you may be familiar with. On the left hand side is where all your layers are contained, and on the right side of the screen is where you would typically find all the design tools. And then going across the top, we have all the shapes that you may want. That's the transform tool, that's the edit frame. You're also able then to export it or play from this. So let's start simple, and I'm going to start off with a sphere. I am going to hold shift as I draw out my sphere, and the reason why I do this is because I want my sphere to stay a complete circle. I could just drop one in, and you can see if I don't hold shift, it will start to make a different shape. You can transform them here, and it is a dark color, so I'm going to change this to yellow. And I can also hold down my space bar, and if I do that, then this hand comes up, which means I can drag my page. It has these arrows, and it also has this little curve going on here. Pull the up arrow, I can move it up and down. This arrow, I can move it side to side. This then also allows me to rotate the shape. So what makes this tool 3D? Now it's a lot easier to see when there's two shapes on the page. Then I'm going to hold down my Alt key and drag. Now you can start to see that this is 3D. Now if you get a bit lost, what I usually do is come down here to reset and it will go back to the very beginning. That's the basics on the shape. So what else can you do in Spline? Then I'm going to put a few little shapes on the page. Same thing again, hold down the Alt. The cube doesn't look 3D, but it actually is 3D. And then I'm going to do the same thing again, which is Alt and drag. And again, you can now start to see that it's actually 3D. When you come down to visibility, I can change it to whether I want it to show as a wireframe. Again, this doesn't look 3D, but again, as you start to move, it definitely is 3D. So make this a little bit smaller, and I'm holding my Alt key as I do this. I can also pull this out as well, which makes it a little bit larger, or I can make it really, really small if I wanted to. So what's cool about this is that I can change the slice and it becomes half. So now we have all of our shapes that we would like to play with. We can also add some text in, so I'm just going to do that. So as you can see now, everything is pretty much in place and it's all pretty much 3D. Just now that I've added some shapes and some text, now let's take a look at some states and some events. Again, over here in the right hand bar, if I select one of my shapes, I have this little thing here called state and something else called event. Let's click on a state. We have a base state and state one. On state one, I am going to change my color to red. I also want to move it up. So I have my base and then I have my state. So let's add an event. Mouse down, mouse up, mouse hover, key down, key up, start, look at, and follow. Now I want to add in a hover. So that means if I hover over this element, it will start to move. I don't want a cycle to happen and I don't want a repeat to happen, and the transition is going to be ease and out. So I can hit this little play button here. This is my little design that I put together. But what happens if I hover over this? Ooh, it moves. And you can do that for pretty much all the other elements. State one, I want it to move up. Start, I want this to repeat. I want this to spring. Spring in, hovers. Woohoo, cool. Okay, awesome. Now, another cool feature is that I can also add in a link to this button. Again, I can add a state. I can add an event. And right here then on mouse down, so that means if something is clicked, put in a URL here, should open up my website. And there you go. Another cool interaction that you can add into your design. So now let's talk about how you would embed spine into your website. It's pretty easy and it's a lot easier than you may think. Right at the top here, we have this nice little export button. So if I click here, it'll give me some options. So I can either do a public URL, I could do a web content, I could do an image, I can even do a video and so on. So I'm going to go with public URL. So I'm going to export this and then Spline is going to do his magic. I have two options, which is a public URL or I can embed it into my website. I'm just going to go with this option right now. And I'm going to jump over to my website. All that's in this page right now is a navigation bar, but I do have a HTML embedded into it as well, which I have the option to paste in some custom code. Going to click save, easily use this now. So if I click the preview page and my animations are starting, so my high is bouncing around and all of my interactions are working. I can also drag and rotate it. So this was very, very easy to embed into my website. You do have the Spline logo in the bottom here because this is the free version, but that's okay. And yes, my interactions and my buttons do actually work. And that's it. That's Spline. You can do some awesome, crazy, creative things within Spline. Just the other day, I created this fun little robot that you can pretty much just take the creativity any way that you can. I'll leave a link to my little robot in the description just so you can check it out. You can download Spline right now and try it out for free. There's a link in the description below, so check out their website, maybe download the tool or use it in the browser, whichever suits you. And please put your Spline projects in the comments below so I can take a look at what you create. If you want to follow me on Instagram, you can do so here. And until next time, bye!